Hi, this is the second Andek Cocoon 111 video, and I just want to thank the Andek Corporation for allowing me to run with this product and market around the world. I want to thank Harvey Liss, Andrew Liss, and I also like to thank my chief chemist, Neil Scherer. I call him my sensei, because as a Wall Street mind, it has taken a little bit for me to understand the true value and the problems that we can solve with chemistry. And on another note, as you can see, we're sitting here in Maniloki, New Jersey, Barnegat Bay, where I was fortunate enough to grow up, and I have no chance of doing this without my sunglasses, so excuse me. The target audience for today is the marine industry, militaries, both domestic and foreign, any heavy equipment manufacturer, boat manufacturer, or anyone that's moving goods that they need to preserve, protect, and keep clean in a non-toxic and non-flammable environment. Also, freight forwarders, manufacturers of goods and services, we're going to cobble together a stack of boxes and we're gonna spray, and you'll see the webbing. That's important for anyone that's moving cardboard boxes. If you saw the first video, you saw where the product was easily removed from cardboard. We'll do that again. The auto industry, there was that huge explosion in China, and the real reason that that fire in China was such a disaster is because there was 8,000 cars sitting next to that factory which caught on fire, and the shrink wrap went up in absolute flames. That's what makes this product so unique, and this will be the last time I say it, but please take note. Non-flammable, non-contributory, non-toxic, residue-free removal, and it is recyclable. I've learned a lot about chemistry. With 111, we deal with fugitive plasticides, which is a microbe that exists between the actual compound and the surface. So if you spray a piece of glass, 111 never actually adheres to the glass. There is a microbial level that prevents adherence. I learned a lot about plastics in this past week because on the first video, I sprayed Erica's car and I sprayed some of the rubber. And when I went back to Neil and said, Neil, what the heck? He said, well, Sean, this was invented by the DOD for tanks and airplanes. There weren't really rubber parts, so this is what we have to do next. I learned about thermosets and thermoplastics. Thermosets are the good guys. They're hard plastics, fiberglass. Those are things that 111 won't stick to. And then there are thermoplastics, styrofoam, rubber, Ziploc bags, those kinds of rubbers will adhere to the 111 product because of the chemistry. We're also going to do a burn test on the things that we're going to spray today, and then we'll do a removal as we did in the first video. And hopefully this video is better. I'm getting better at hopefully filming and editing. I'm zipping through my cards here. Oh, as a teaser, my lovely assistant Erica put in here, this spring for the marine industry, Andek will be presenting a bottom coat solution. This will be a soft non-biocide solution, does not fall under EPA control. It is a combination of three Andek products, Vinyl Bond B, Andek 560, and Andek FP. We can bring those products to market, we believe, at a price point of about $80 a gallon. It only has to be sprayed once every 8 to 10 years. Barnacles will not adhere to it, we believe, and barnacles will actually fall off a moving surface that's coated with our solution. This is an incredibly huge market, but it just goes to show you what chemistry can do. We're excited about that. It's currently in with the Poseidon Foundation in India, and we should have results in 4 to 5 months. I think that covers everything that I wanted to say. Again, I just want to thank Andek Corporation for allowing me to market this incredible compound. And if you have any questions, there will be information on the video. And I think that just about covers it. Thank you very much, and let's get to it.
All right, ready to go. I have a 30% webbing agent to 111. I'm not going to show you me spraying the whole thing. I'll just break in and show you some of the webbing across the gaps in the boxes. That's important. The boxes are not stacked uniformly. They're a little bit oblong in places, and I want to fill that in and show you how this encapsulates boxes for shipping, for storage.
All right, we put a quick top coating of 111 on the boxes. You can see the webbing bonding between the boxes. Right there's a good shot. And this coating right here would be a sufficient coating for shrink wrap. And as you can see, you can read the labels underneath the 111 clear. So that's why I sprayed this to show to freight forwarders the versatility of the product and that you can use it right here. That is a coating that will peel off the box and you can read the label clearly.
Hi, we're back in Maniloki, New Jersey, and I'm going to spray this Prindle Catamaran. It's a fiberglass boat. Back in the day, this was one of my racing boats, a victim of Hurricane Sandy, much like my childhood home. It should be pretty easy to spray and unwrap. And when I do start spraying, I'm going to run the camera continuously and then shrink the camera in fast motion mode so you're not looking at me standing around too much. Let's get to spraying.
Incidentally, this is white tinted 111. The cardboard boxes had clear. The metal military locker was white. This is going to be white. And obviously, if you're someone in the marine industry, this is a coating for your shrink wrapping for your boats. And it's a non-flammable, non-toxic compound, residue-free, removable, recyclable. Let's go. Okay, here we go with the flame. You can see that the flame is irritating the product, but it is not catching fire. It's called non-contributory. The fire is extinguishing upon contact. If this were shrink wrap, we'd have a problem. Okay, this is the last leg of information. As you can see, here's our Bacardi box. If you're in shipping, you can see what's in this box. Let's put a flame on it. This is your warehouse. That's the burn part of it. You can see it's not catching fire. Maybe aggravating a little bit. That's about it. Now let's do the splash test. Oh, it's raining on all of our products. Now, let's unwrap it. Deep there. Coming right off the cardboard. And the cardboard is still dry. Okay, let's do our burn and removal from the green metal box. See that it is aggravating the surface, but there is no fire. Now let's unwrap it. Get a good look at this surface. You can see residue-free removal. After all, this is the surface that the DOD designed the product to handle. Not only that, but non-toxic.